The options and the outcomes are unlike anything else in the world. Presenting The Challenge of Flight, a series that shows it all, good and bad, the way fighter pilots have seen it for years. You are now a part of this community. Each episode opens new doors with dramatic footage that gives you the inside track on this incredible world of military aviation. Accidents are unexpected. Camera coverage, if any, is often on the run. On carriers, sophisticated optics partly obscure the field of view, each of which hurts the quality of the film you're about to see. As has age, much of the footage is old, passed down from originals long since lost. Some detail is included. Most is withheld in accordance with the policies of the Department of Defense. But much can be learned from these scenes. Pilots know this, good or bad, that these are true stories from the challenge of flight. Pilots have a special relationship with flight. Though they live for their time in the air, they understand better than anyone that man was not meant to fly, that every moment off the ground is a challenge to nature's fundamental rules. Still, they are drawn to the air, to the beauty, the wonder, the feeling of twisting alone through the clouds. But the reality is always there. And when pilots talk, it's not so much about joy as challenge, and not so much about soaring through the clouds as it is teetering precariously above the ground.
Well, it's almost like Peter Pan, where they can fly. I've had that dream, and unfortunately, we can't do that. That is just fantasy, but in an airplane, you can fly. Attractions to flying is that it's a skill, and that it's a skill that I've been able to master. And I get some satisfaction out of the fact that it's not easy, and I can do it, and some other people can't do it.
Pilots collect stories, trading close calls, the way kids trade baseball cards. With the advent of home video, pilots started to collect and trade footage, real-life images released from official accident investigation files. Much of the footage you are about to see has never been seen anywhere but on those pilot tapes. Some have deteriorated into ghostly tales of caution. Traced to the original government film and video, they've been declassified especially for this documentary. The quality of the images is sometimes unclear, but the reality they represent is in sharp focus. The story they tell is of the final approach. We'll be right back. To fly, the pilot has to survive the transition from ground to air. To tell the tale, he's got to get safely back down. Takeoff and landing. That small portion of the flight is where most disasters happen. In those few seconds, there's simply not enough time or enough slack in the envelope to react. In the next two sequences, aborted landings quickly turn into a struggle to get the jet flying. This F-100 can't make it back into the envelope. This F-8F, in an almost identical situation, is saved by the extra height of the carrier deck. Room to push the nose down and gain precious lift. Perhaps the hardest decision a pilot faces is how to deal with a crippled airplane. The answer is almost always the same. Get it on the ground. Somehow, with brute strength, with foam on the runway, with your heart in your throat. Here are the blown tires, the burning brakes, and the hard landings with damaged gear that make every flight a new challenge. As all but the luckiest pilots know, the failure of one system invariably leads to the failure of another. This XB-70 starts with a single blown tire. Watch it spread across the entire undercarriage. the barrier. What few outside the pilot community know is that the tailhook, long the hallmark of naval aviation, also flies with the fighter jets of the Air Force. Why the hook? To grab the wire or barrier that often means the difference between an uneventful recovery and disaster. Blown tires, broken gear, bad brakes, chute malfunctions, loss of electrical or hydraulic systems. They're all reason to call for the barrier, a mechanism not unlike the arresting wires on the deck of the carrier. This F-15 sequence shows a classic land-based barrier arrestment, this filmed at Edwards Air Force Base using high-speed cameras. In this F-4 sequence, the runway portion of the cable's rig is clearly seen. Donut-like spacers elevate the wire slightly, enough to give the hook a sure target, but not so high as to snag the landing gear as the nose wheel crosses it. The pilot lines up the approach by aiming for a touchdown point some 300 feet before and in the center of the cable, but not on the center line of the runway where the raised painted lines will interfere with a smooth engagement. There's good reason for this. Watch the hook as it skips during the initial contact with the ground. The extra distance allows the jet and the hook to settle down on the runway for a sure engagement with the cable. Where forged iron and hard concrete meet, sparks are sure to fly. No exception is made for the barrier-arrested landing, a true spectacle day or night. The barrier mechanism firmly brings a jet to a safe stop without pulling off the undercarriage of lighter jets like this F-16. In most cases, 500 to 1,000 feet of wire will play out, the initial contact passing a decisive jolt into the cockpit. The thin trailing link hook of the F-16 makes a clean pickup. A wing-mounted, lipstick-sized camera gives us an unusual view of the barrier arrest. The speed across the threshold will be about 130 to 140 knots. In the sometimes unnatural world of complex systems, moments of poetic beauty appear quite unexpectedly, as it did when viewing the cable from this next angle. Foam, to control sparks and the danger of fire. In all emergency landings, fire and rescue equipment are called out, not because, but rather just in case. Pilots and ground crew are always trained for the worst case. In our final sequence, we see firsthand the payoff for developing systems like the barrier and for the training to fly to a successful engagement. This payoff brings an F-4 to an uneventful recovery, much to the relief of its crew. earlier, we saw the F-16 unexpectedly take flight during a high-speed taxi test. Watch now at a picture-perfect gear-up landing. For some jets, a safety truck is simply part of a landing rollout. With its long, spindly wings and its narrow tandem gear, the U-2 is as likely to ground loop as not. So each landing is closely followed and monitored for safety as well as training. Nothing cripples a jet faster than lost electrics or hydraulics. This early F-14 tries to stretch it out, but ultimately pitches over just short of the threshold as it loses its last drop of precious hydraulic fluid. Incredibly, the front and back seaters walk away. Naval aviation poses special challenges. Compressing a 2-mile-long runway into a couple of hundred feet on a ship's deck makes normal takeoff and landing impossible. The systems designed to make carrier flight possible pose their own challenges to pilots. In this selection of shots, you'll see catapults misfiring, landing gear shattering, tail hooks snapping, and the last hope of a Navy pilot with a bad plane, barrier arrestments.
Rattle's going off. Eject. you are clear of the deck, off the front, you turn to the right, and off the waist, you turn to the left to clear away from the front of the aircraft carrier. So that if something happened and you had to bail out or eject immediately, that the carrier wouldn't run over you. In the A6. 200, over 200 of those are at night, and I can tell you one thing, not one of them was fun. They're all work, it's very challenging.
Find out how men and equipment react in emergencies. A special breed of pilot deliberately flies planes into trouble. Here are planes and helicopters, sometimes remotely controlled, packed with telemetry and destroyed.
When I get in a jet like an A6, that's work. That's and that mission and that airframe demand a certain level of professionalism. And if they don't, I could either hurt the airframe or kill myself. I don't think it's inherently dangerous. I think it's inherently hazardous, okay? And I make a differentiation there because dangerous implies that inevitably something, somewhere, somebody's gonna die, okay? And hazardous means you cut your variables down to almost zero, okay? So if there is a breakdown in teamwork, if there is a breakdown in maintenance, if there is a breakdown in the professionalism of the level of pilots, yes, it gets dangerous, but it doesn't have to be dangerous. something that just anybody can jump in an airplane and do. It's something that requires that step above to be able to apply what you know in a way that's the best for your situation. Of course, your life on the line or your life at stake, the outcome is very important. Are overly romantic about flight don't last a long time. They either kill themselves or they're trident in training.
Why do they fly? What is it about aviation that draws pilots? And what is it that convinces them that the risks aren't theirs to bear?
There's a place,
the pilots will tell you, where tension becomes joy, where nervousness becomes excitement, where fear becomes control.
Control of the craft, of the variables, of one's own emotions and reflexes is the ultimate challenge of flight. Flyers of high-performance aircraft spend hundreds of hours skimming a learning curve that can kill them. Training, planning, dwelling on possibilities that most of us, settling into the comfort of an airliner seat, do everything to avoid even considering.
The engine fails on takeoff. What if I have some type of gear malfunction on takeoff? The critical action things that require instantaneous action, where you don't have a whole lot of time to think, guys will try to think about those ahead of time so they properly react if the problem comes up. Flying is not a natural ability, it's an acquired ability. Aviation is a series of challenges that you overcome.
Thank you.
You're in hiding. You're holding. So Yeah. I don't wanna sell tonight. Welcome to the jungle! myself in time. The underlying key. Yeah. Welcome to the jungle. lick, lick. Shovels up the light window, making sure I'm awake. It's probably gonna rip my brain. Got me in a vice-like grip. He said, I wanna flip, and you're dead. Scooty creature of heaven, little horror here to stay. If anyone in his right mind would die to go away. But the river of fear runs deep.
I'm going to go to the hospital.